Hello, my name is Elena Cannon, and I'm with the Solutions team here at ESRI. Today, I'm going to demonstrate a common workflow using our as-built editing and analysis solution for gas utilities. Before we begin, make sure you have downloaded and added all the correct tools to your map. For directions, visit our website at solutions.arcgis.com and search for the as-built editing and analysis solution. A common editing task is to add new features to the network. In this example, I need to update the map to reflect a recently completed project in a new subdivision. I begin by starting an edit session. From the Create Features window, I can see the various types of features that I can add to the map. In this example, I need to add a 2-inch plastic pipe. I begin by selecting a 2-inch plastic pipe and using the Trace tool. With an offset value of 15 feet to follow along the edge of the property line. Once I add the line, I can update the attribute information. Note that the majority of the fields are pre-populated. The fields highlighted in yellow are required fields. Once I fill out the attribute information, I can update the location of the annotation. In this example, we are using a feature-linked annotation, so any attributes that are updated on the pipe that support annotations will automatically be updated in the annotation feature class shown here. In this example, I will update the install date to the current year, which is automatically captured in the annotation. Next, I will add an end cap to the main. You will notice that the end cap fitting attributes were pulled from the existing pipe that it is attached to. This is done by using the attribute assistant rules, which automate those business rules when adding new features. Next, I need to add one more main east of the newly added pipe. I add a T with a pipe split function, which automatically generates a new annotation for the new section of pipe. It is important to split the pipe to help ensure that proper white space management rules are applied. I will add a new pipe by first snapping to the newly added T and again using the trace tool with an offset value of 15 feet from the property line. I will once again update the attributes and finally I will adjust the annotation location. I will add an end cap to wrap up this piece and enter the appropriate attribute information. Finally, I need to add a gas valve to the network. I first select the type of valve, location, and update the attribute information. You will notice that I will change the install and in-service dates. These were picked up from the original pipe and need to be updated. In this example, I use the feature template to auto-populate the attributes prior to adding the features to the map. I also use the attribute assistant rules to update the attributes based on what features they were attached to. I finally use the core editing tools to update and adjust the features as needed.